There were certain random thoughts in my mind, so I felt that for a change, for a few minutes I'll just get across to you. This is different. This is some problem which you will be seeing very soon. It's lengthy, so I don't know. Uploading will take time. Now, I just want to say that how to utilize this lockdown period in your life. Lockdown, and your life. First of all, getting into NIT, IIT, IIIT, or anything else, or AIIMS or other medical colleges is good. Is good, but it is not necessarily great. Not necessarily. It can be great, but it is not necessarily great. What I mean to say is, getting into IIT, NIIT, whatever, is not end of life. Life doesn't come to an end here. This success is merely one part of your, one phase of your life. There are multiple barriers in your life. Whole life, you will come across these barriers. And you are what you are doing, whole our life we are basically doing this hurdle race. We are chasing something, and somebody sees something, he is chasing that. Somebody sees money, he is chasing that. Somebody sees fame, he is chasing that. So each one of us has our own imagination of success, and we are madly chasing it. Like we also chased it at some point of time. For me, IAS meant success. So after engineering, I worked very hard for IAS, got into it. Then I realized there is more to success. The meaning is different. Means life has multiple dimensions. So qualifying an exam is good. It gives you a social standing and status, especially in a country like ours. It gives you some kind of a respect and reputation. But if you are not able to qualify it, don't think that you have lost out on everything. You can still become great without becoming good. Means without going to this phase of what you call is success, is a limited success. So anyway, I was just talking about lockdown and how to use it, this some habits which you you will inculcate during these days of lockdown. And those habits should help you in your life. One is social distancing. Now, this is the life, this is the age of social networking sites. Social networks, great word. Social networks. Everybody is on WhatsApp, Instagram, whatnot, Insta, Face, and lot many other things. And we are just subsumed into that. So first of all, as a student, maintain distance from these. Not the social distance during the lockdown period, also the network distance. What lockdown may unfortunately do is, we may have social distance, but we may stick to network. Just to reduce the boredom from one is social aspect of life, pure social, which happens in physical terms. Physically we meet somebody, and one is in through net. So we are maintaining social distance physically, but through network we still have that social network, and it consumes a lot of our time. It eats into our vital time. So as a student, you should try to maintain social network distance. Use this lockdown period not for partial inculcation of habit. Inculcate this full habit of social network, and network separately and social separately distance, so that you are able to focus on your studies. focus is the ultimate thing. Means if you are able to focus, single-minded devotion to what you want to achieve. Again, with a caveat and means a rider, that it's a different matter that that is not the ultimate success. Getting into IIT or NIT, that is not the ultimate success. But for you, that is your immediate goal. No harm in trying to achieve that goal. If you achieve that goal, fine. But that goal should be for something greater and good. That goal should not be just to qualify that exam and that's end of it. So to do that, you will have to work hard. So don't maintain hard work distancing. People tend to maintain hard work distancing. And we end up then cursing the system and so many other things that. But we also are not fond of hard work distance. We should be away from the hard work distance. Means we should be towards the hard work. Another thing, another lockdown should tell us, lockdown should teach us as a part of this great country is that we should maintain corruption distancing. Corruption distancing. That is very, very important. This is eating into our system. So if we, the lockdown period, social distancing, network distancing, social network distancing should also help as a society in maintaining this corruption distancing, because if we are not able to do that, then all our efforts are useless. We are just, corruption is what? Corruption is not merely money. Corruption, look at 360 degree implication of corruption. It is corruption in our thoughts, corruption in our what we promise and what we don't do, what we say, what we preach. You see a lot of preachers, and some of the great preachers are in jail. So they were not, it was not that they were doing some illegal activity of making money, but they were corrupt in their thoughts. So 360 degree honesty, we should try to strive using the lockdown period as a phase where we have to control our actions. We are controlling one part of the action of not going out, but control the rest of the action, which is basically, which starts from our mind. This mind takes us in all the directions. So try to train your mind, try to inculcate habit of some meditation during this period. And I was very impressed by one lecture at the YouTube channel of Arvind Academy. He talks about positive thinking and gives a very good quotation by one of the thinkers who wrote the book on power of positive thinking. So use this period as a phase of improving your life as a whole. Just a small message, maybe I bored you, but these thoughts were coming in my mind. I thought I'll just get across.